All right, we are pleased to be joined by Tony Frye, founder of Hero Habit. Tony had a prior engagement. It looks like he did not get back to his computer in time, but look how savvy he is, showing up via mobile. Awesome. Tony, welcome to GoGTS Live.
Love it.
Thanks for having us.
Absolutely. Ivan was one of the first people that helped me get familiar with Hero Habit and been paying attention to what you guys are doing. But for people who aren't familiar with what Hero Habit is, in the your own words as the founder, tell us a little bit about Hero Habit and why you started it.
Basically, Hero Habit is just a site dedicated to pop culture and sports news, as well as the collectibles. So we're kind of a mixed message where you'll come to read our hot takes on the Toronto Blue Jays and then stay and buy some baseball cards with some mixed content and that covers both topics. And that's about it. You know, we're trying to build a little community of casual collectors that maybe have dropped out of the hobby, or, you know, guys that are my age that grew up in the junk era that didn't know the cards were cool again and that had some value and could, you know, be a fun collectible. Try to get them back and then appeal to the diehards who are looking for Aaron Judge autographs and things of that nature.
Yeah, well, and I can't stress enough. First off, you are pulled over. We just saw a biker zoom past you, so you're clearly not moving. We appreciate that and your dedication to the show. How absolutely awesome is that? Because we all know so many sports fans that don't collect. Why is that? How do we solve that problem? How do we change that perspective? And when you first told me that that was the focus, that it's not just here's checklists and here's who's signing, it's really appealing to the sports fan. Can you share with us just some numbers on an average article, or just reach, or what you've seen as far as conversions go? Because I know that your following is so much more than just hobby followers.
Mm-hmm. As far as the conversion, it's hard to gauge right now. We just launched the storefront about 3 weeks ago. And it's surprising me that we've actually been pulling a lot on the entertainment side. We had some Parks and Recreation autographs that went within 10 minutes of me launching the store officially. I sold a Rob Lowe autograph. So, I mean, there are certain people that are into sports, that are into television, and they don't even know. They don't know that they autograph cards now. They don't know about relic cards. I was talking to a big sports fan that didn't have any idea that they put, like, jerseys in cards, you know, and he was shocked when he saw how thick the card stock was for these things. I mean, there's just it's not an ignorance, but it's just changed a lot since we were kids. And that's kind of the main demographic I'm tapping into so far, is a lot of guys that are, you know, in their 30s that collected when they were kids and have all those 91 Fleer cards that, you know, aren't worth anything. They have no idea how, you know, how much is going on in the hobby right now.
Very cool. And now I understand you do breaks. They're just not what we think of when we think of group breaks.
Right. So the idea behind that was, and that's kind of where I appeal to every aspect of the collector. The idea was, I'll break the cases and post them on the website. And for the diehard collectors that want to collect autographs, they can just come and buy the autograph, and they don't have to end up with six full complete team sets like you would if you bought into a group break. And then by doing that, it also allows me to sell six complete team sets to casual people that might just want to buy them for their kids when they're going to a baseball game, you know, to get their own autographs and things like that. And I'm seeing a good response. I'm seeing some people picking up autograph cards and their team sets, so it's as if they bought into a break. And then I'm seeing people just spending the $4, $5 and getting, you know, all of their favorite players in one shot without having to open a bunch of packs, or, you know, maybe that's their gateway back into the hobby to see what it's all about.
Very cool. One of the things that I did notice that first drew my eye was those Park and Recreation autographs, because one of my all-time favorite shows and a great product back in the day, as they say. But looking at some of the talking about how products have changed, what are some of the products you've seen this year or that are coming out this year that you're intrigued by?
So far, I think my favorite set this year was the Panini Diamond Kings. That was just a fun one to break. I got a great case that had was full of awesome hits. And it'd been a long time since I opened Diamond Kings, admittedly. You know, I'm one of those guys that prefers the licensed stuff, but this year changed my mind. And, you know, they're good every year, but this year really changed my mind on that one. That was the big one. It's, you know, it's cool to see all the daily stuff, like the Tops Now and everything, being popular, but I don't really deal with that. But, yeah, the Panini Diamond Kings this year, that was a highlight for me so far.
I agree with
you. Well, and I noticed... Sorry, I was just really excited because I noticed something else that you did on Twitter 3 days ago and then again just recently with Donald Trump's viral tweet that he deleted.
Yeah.
It's the one thing. That's a whole other story. It's the one time he's truly angered me, though. Don't delete your tweet. Own it. Side story. Where because of your unique status selling individual cards, even though you're a news and... news site, you offer discounts periodically, so people need to be following you on social media,
right?
And so tell us a little bit about that one, especially the one with the viral tweet and the Aaron Judge, because I thought those were really cool.
Well, the Aaron Judge, he got, I forget what was the milestone, was it two home runs? I think it was his first multiple
home runs and like some, like there was some other like five RBI outside of that,
it was
or something
his first
crazy.
Grand Slam. It was his first Grand Slam,
yes.
And I'm an A's fan, and he was playing the A's, so I had to watch it happen, which seems to happen a lot this year. But so right after he hit that, we had the coupon code Salami, and you could get – I forget what the discount was, but you could get a discount off anything. And we do have an Aaron Judge card that's been sitting there for a couple of weeks that I'm surprised nobody's picked up yet. And then for the Donald Trump, the Comfifi tweet, that was just a promo code that, you know, it was getting a lot of traction, and I'm never one to shy away from a hot hashtag. So I glommed onto it, and, you know, I drove some traffic. We got more off of the Salami than the Comfifi tweet because nobody wanted to leave Twitter and miss all the fun. But, you know, if you follow that, we're doing some stuff like on Instagram and Facebook periodically and through the newsletter. If you sign up for that, there's usually a coupon code with that every week as well.
Very cool. So the cards are actually available on herohabit.com?
Right.
Okay, cool. That was actually a question from a viewer, and I just wanted to clarify. And then what about the news? Like, is it just you writing the articles, or what's the team like, or what are you building there with the news and the marketing side of it?
I do a lot of the baseball stuff and a lot of the trading card-specific stuff. There are a few other writers. We've got a Canadian writer who does my Saturday Night Live posts. A buddy of mine, Nick Avila, who's been writing for me for years on various other sites, does a lot of the football, basketball, and WWE content. And then we have a couple other guest writers. Kraken Wax, who some of you may know, has started contributing video content that he's sharing with us. And then... the folks at High Heat Stats are providing some of the best baseball content that that we've had. Some real good analytical, historical analysis, some deep stat stuff that really appeals to the baseball nerd more than anything. But they're great content coming from High Heat Stats as well. So we've got some partnerships with some of those kind of guys that are providing a lot of good content for people that aren't interested in cards, they still might just want to come and learn more about baseball or basketball or anything.
Social, where do you hang out? Twitter, Facebook, Instagram?
Everything. I'm even on LinkedIn for the first time. I don't understand how it works, but I'm there. Everything is at Hero Habit. one word, at Hero Habit. You can get me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Tumblr, Pinterest, LinkedIn. I think that's all of them.
Okay.
Did I just hear Tinder? Are you on Tinder?
No, I'm not. But...
How about that? How about that? A swipe right for cards. Who's going to create that?
That'll be phase three of the website. We'll do that for the next phase.
Yeah.
Nice. So everyone, be sure to check out herohabit.com. We will let you get back to your evening, sir. But Tony, I really appreciate you taking some time out. Keep up the great work, and we'll have you back on again in the future. How's that sound?
I'll come by anytime.
Awesome. Thanks, Tony.
Thank you.
All righty. Tony Frye, founder of HeroHabit.com, a returning collector, doing his part to get sports fans into the hobby. Gotta love it. Gotta love it.